Produce Safety Alliance sanitizer list is a reference to help growers and educators choose an EPA-labeled antimicrobial pesticide appropriate for their operations needs. In this tool, we refer to antimicrobial pesticides simply as sanitizers. Just a note, the PSA does not endorse any particular product on this list. This list is a compilation of sanitizers on the market and is not all-inclusive. Additionally, the information on this list is intended to serve as an educational tool, but the content does not necessarily reflect the viewpoints and policies of the organizations that support and cooperate within the PSA or Cornell University. And lastly, since EPA labels are continually being updated, users are encouraged to double-check any information found here against the product's EPA label. The PSA sanitizer list is a compilation of EPA-labeled sanitizers labeled for fruit and vegetable washing. The list also includes sanitizers labeled for food contact surfaces and irrigation water. Looking at the tool, the PSA sanitizer list is divided into four sections: the main page, which is what we see here, active ingredients, label information, and product information. The four sections can be explored by clicking through the buttons at the top of the columns. This first tab in the PSA sanitizer list is the main page. The top left corner displays the date that this list was last revised. The PSA will update this list at least annually, and this revision date can be checked to ensure that the most updated version of the list is used. You will see that the main page consists of two columns: trade name and other trade names. The trade name column includes the EPA registered name of the sanitizer. These names are listed as they appear on the federal EPA label. The second column, other trade names, includes alternative names that the product may be marketed under. These names are also listed as they appear on the EPA label. One of the most useful parts of this tool is the filter function. Many of the columns in the PSA sanitizer list can be filtered by specific text. Just look for the downward-facing arrow button in the column headings. Once the arrow is clicked, specific sanitizers may be filtered or selected for. This function is helpful if you are interested in combing the list for specific product names. The next tab can be accessed by clicking on the Active Ingredients button. Just as in the first tab, the trade name column is found on the left, and there is also a button to return to the main page. Each of the pink columns contain information on the sanitizer's active ingredient and strength. The majority of active ingredients on the PSA sanitizer list are oxidizers, including hypochlorites and peroxyacetic acid, or PAA. Just as a reminder, this sheet will allow you to filter the list by a specific active ingredient. When working with a grower who is only interested in peroxyacetic acid sanitizers, you can filter this list by clicking the arrow under oxidizers. The drop-down menu will list several options. Uncheck the Select All options and choose PAA with hydrogen peroxide. Once the filter is selected, you can see that only PAA products are listed. The next section of the PSA sanitizer list can be accessed by clicking on the Label Information button. This sheet is probably where users will spend the most time. The label information sheet is separated into two primary categories: approvals and registrations, and EPA label. Under approvals and registrations, the first column lists the product's EPA registration number as it appears on the EPA label. The registration number is specific to the sanitizer and can be useful when searching for more information on the product. The second column under approvals and registrations is named OMRI listing. This column identifies whether the product is listed by the Organic Materials Review Institute, or OMRI, for organic use. In some cases, additional details can be found in the notes section on the right. And as always, be sure to check with your organic certifier before using any new products on a certified organic operation. The second broad category is the EPA label section. The first column contains a link to a PDF of the label. When clicked, it will send you to the EPA's website. The next few columns list if the sanitizer is labeled for certain uses. These applications include non-porous food contact surfaces, washing fruits and vegetables, and irrigation water. Each column lists if the product is labeled for a certain use. If a product is labeled for that use, we have included the page number where the specific instructions can be found in the label PDF. Using AccuTab as an example, we see that it is labeled for non-porous food contact surfaces, washing fruits and vegetables, and for use in irrigation water. Here, I have pulled up the EPA label for AccuTab by clicking on the Label PDF hyperlink. We can find the instructions for washing fruits and vegetables on page 22 of this PDF document. The fifth column under the broad EPA label category lists whether the product is labeled to control public health organisms. These organisms may include pathogens such as Salmonella enterica and Listeria monocytogenes. If a sanitizer is labeled for public health organisms, the specific use is listed in the column. Again, using AccuTab as an example, we see that it is not labeled to control public health organisms. Looking down on the list, we see that antimicrobial fruit and vegetable treatment is for the specific labeled use of washing fruits and vegetables. The EPA label information is important to consider because the sanitizer that growers use will need to be labeled for its intended use. This intended use might include sanitizing non-porous food contact surfaces or managing post-harvest water quality. If a grower is using a sanitizer to manage post-harvest water quality, the product needs to be labeled for fruit and vegetable washing. Some auditors may require that the sanitizer also be labeled to control public health organisms. We've included a column called EPA accepted date. This information can be used to make sure that the sanitizer's EPA label is the most current. And lastly, the notes section contains any additional information that may be relevant for each sanitizer. The last tab in this tool, the product information tab, only contains two columns. The first column is a quantity of product purchasable pulled directly from the EPA label. This information may be useful if a grower only needs a small amount of sanitizer or vice versa. The last column lists the manufacturer for each sanitizer. That concludes the tutorial for the PSA sanitizer list. Just as a reminder, the revised date can be found on the main page of the sanitizer list. This tool will be updated as necessary, at least annually. So if you have any questions, suggested sanitizers, or corrections related to the PSA sanitizer list, please contact me, Donna Paul, at dmp274@cornell.edu.